Okay, I'm here with Don Bosco quarterback Gary Nova on the heels of a 42-9 victory over St. Peter's. Gary, you were 0-for-6 in the first half. You came out like a horse out of the starting gate in the second half, 3 touchdown passes. Tell me, what inspired you at halftime?
My teammates, you know, my teammates and the coaches, you know, they all talked to me. They said, keep your head up, you know. Tony Jones, you know, carried us in the first half. And I was trying to do too much with the ball, trying to look down the field instead of taking what the defense was giving me. So in the second half, they just talked to me, said, keep doing what I'm doing, and it worked out.
Were you frustrated that you had 6 incompletions in the first half? Were you a little frustrated?
Yeah, definitely. You know, any quarterback's frustrated when the ball is not being completed. But I knew we were going to get it done in the second half.
With this victory over St. Peter's, you now take over the power points, and nothing's really official until Monday morning, but I would say you are the number one seed.
Oh, yeah, but, you know, it's a great thing to be the number one seed, but now we got a target on our backs now. Everybody's going to come looking for us, and they're going to come with a chip on their shoulder when they play us.
So a lot of jackets in the stands, Bergen Catholic. I don't think they're going away.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I hope we see them again, you know. We didn't play as well as we wanted to last time, but I hope we see them again.
Okay, thanks a lot, Gary.
Thank you.
Hey, Coach Greg Dole of the Don Bosco and Ironman with a 42-9 victory over the St. Peter's Marauders. Coach, what can this team do wrong? They're pretty much perfect.
Well, I don't know about that perfect. There's plenty of mistakes out there that, you know, need to be corrected. But I tell you what, hey, our kids played hard, and we're proud of them. You know, that's you either get better or you get worse this time of year, and hopefully we continue to get better. It'll be, you know, Bergen Catholic gave us a heck of a fight, and this is a good football team, St. Peter's too. So another time it could really be a heck of a football game.
And speaking of Bergen Catholic, we have the playoffs next week. Nothing's really official until Monday morning. They could be somebody you're seeing in the first round. With the victory over St. Peter's, you pretty much took over the power points.
Yeah, hey, we're not concerned about who we got to play. Whoever we got to play, we got to play. You know, whatever we play, if we get Bergen in the first round, we get Bergen in the first round. Now, you know what? We're sure not going to duck anybody, that's for sure.
Okay, thanks a lot, Coach.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Okay, Anthony Source here with the unstoppable Tony Jones at Granite Hills Stadium on the heels of a 42-9 victory over the St. Peter Marauders. Tony, 226 yards of total offense in the first half, the 90-yard kickoff return. Tell me about the kickoff return. St. Peter's drives down the field, 28-yard field goal, 3-0. They're making a statement. You take the kickoff, and you turned up that Bo Jackson run breakaway speed, and there was no stopping you.
I mean, you know, the coach told us, you know, he just really told me, you know, let's just take it back. You know, when I seen the hole, you know, I just really burst up the middle. You know, I just, you know, shook the kicker, and, you know, and my team, you know, they ran down with me and blocked for me. So, you know, I just give all credits to them.
Okay, that offensive line certainly did help you out. Once you've got 10 yards on somebody, you're pretty gone. I don't think anybody's catching you.
Yeah, you know, I just give all credit to my offensive line. You know, they block really well. You know, they block for my quarterback. So, you know, when we play good and our defense play good, you know, we're very hard to beat.
What are you more excited about, the playoffs next week or the SAT scores you just got back?
I mean, you know, I'm very excited about the SAT, because, you know, without my SAT scores, I wouldn't be able to talk to no colleges or, you know, be able to visit any colleges, or the colleges won't be able to, you know, talk to me, because, you know, I just have to get my grades up.
And the MSG awards, too, also help.
I mean, yeah, that was very big for me, so, you know, I love it.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Tony.
No problem, man.
Okay, I'm standing here at Granite Hills Stadium in Ramsey, where the Don Bosco Ironmen have defeated the St. Peter's Marauders by a shutout by a score of 42-9. Don Bosco, the number 2 team in the country, just moved into the number 1 spot for the New Jersey State playoffs they're on top with the power points. And next week with the playoffs, it could be Bergen Catholic, could be St. Peter's, we don't know yet. Nothing will be official until Monday morning. From Granite Hills Stadium, I'm Anthony Source. Stadium, and the Cedar Grove Panthers are the North Jersey Section 1 Group 1 champions. And I'm here with Russ Pagano, defensive standout for the Cedar Grove Panthers. Russ, it's 22-8, 8 seconds to go before the half, and you made the key tackle. Secaucus didn't get in the end zone. I believe that was the turning point of the game.
I mean, it felt great to make the tackle. You know, it helped my team a lot. Obviously, it kept them from scoring, which was probably the best thing right now. But, you know, it was the full-out effort from everyone throughout the whole game that won this game. You know, Patsy Caggiano scoring all those touchdowns for us was great, and then our defense staying composed, even when they were getting big plays on us, was awesome.
Tell me what the mentality was like. They got an early break, the interception, 3 plays they got in the end zone. You're all of a sudden down 8-0.
You know what? We're well coached. I knew we were going to come back. It didn't affect us at all. We stayed composed, and we came back. We knew it was going to happen. We knew this year was our year. You know, we knew this was where we were going to be. We knew we were going to win this game. And, you know, we thank our coaches more than anything for this.
29 years ago, your father was a player for the Belleville Buccaneers in a Group 4 title game against West Essex. Belleville lost 12-7. I know for the 2 weeks coming into this game, your father probably told you nothing about it. I played at Giant Stadium. Now you got the title for him.
Yep, he tells me every day, you know, that it was 30 years ago he played here, you know, make the best of it. So, I mean, that's what I came out here to try to do, you know. Feels great to just win this game, you know, all the seniors together. So it's a great win.
Okay, thanks a lot, Russ. Okay, we're here at Giant Stadium, the Summit Hilltoppers, the North 2 Group 2 state champions in New Jersey, and Coach Liberato hasn't been said in a long time.
It's great. 15 years in the waiting. We were on a mission this year. Now the mission's accomplished, and I'm so proud of our kids being down 2 touchdowns, making 3 turnovers, giving them the ball. Our kids just played together. We have a great community. We have great kids. We're blessed with great kids, and we're blessed with a great community. It's awesome.
I can't agree with you more, Matt Ray. Anybody that doesn't want to recruit him is nuts.
I would agree with you. So, I mean, just look at what he does. You know, we always tell our kids, actions speak louder than words. So hopefully the college recruiters can see that.
I'm here with Marcel Godino. Marcel, how crucial was that touchdown you caught at the end of the half?
I mean, it was big. I felt terrible after that last punt. I just knew I had to do something to get over that punt. And everyone on the team, it just made me feel real good about it. You know, they just told me, keep my head. You know, they told me just, like, stay calm, just forget about it, and something big would happen, and it did.
You bobbled that touchdown pass a little bit. How did you keep your concentration on that?
You know, I was just so focused after I dropped that punt, after I messed that punt up. So I was going all out after that.
And I'm here with Matt Ray. Matt, it looks good on you.
Thank you.
Matt, tell us about the touchdown, the 45-yarder that put you ahead 21-13. You just wouldn't quit till you saw that Giants blue in the end zone.
Well, me and my offensive line are really close, and I told them, give me a little bit of daylight, I'll help you guys out. And I just love every one of them. And I'm really proud of our offense, proud of our seniors, proud of our coaches. I love our coaches. I'm going to miss playing for them.
I know, and this is going to be your last game. You know, someday you're going to get older, you're going to get married, you're going to have kids, you're going to tell them you played your last high school game at the old Giant Stadium in the Meadowlands.
Oh my gosh, that's going to be unbelievable. I mean, I'm trying to get through high school, go to college, so I'll worry about that later.
And I was telling Coach Liberato, any school that doesn't want to take you is crazy.
Well, I mean, every school, whether it's size or speed, I mean, I think I make up for it with determination and passion. I love this game. I love my teammates, and I love my coaches.
Okay, thanks a lot, man. Congratulations. You enjoy it. You deserve it.
Thank you very much.
Okay, here at Giant Stadium, the Don Bosco Ironmen win another state championship, 35-15 over St. Peter's. And I'm here with Tony Jones. And Tony, unlike your meeting a month ago in Ramsey against them, it was all you. They just couldn't stop you.
Yeah, I mean, we worked really hard. So, you know, it's just big for me and my team. You know, I wouldn't be here without my team. So it's just really good for me to come out here and get 4 state championships in a row. And it's just to win it with my team at Giant Stadium. So it's big. Because, you know, the Giant Stadium is getting knocked down. So we made history.
The snow coming down, did that ruin your visibility trying to find those holes at all? Look like it for Mike throwing up in the press box.
I mean, you know, it didn't, you know, ruin nothing. It just, you know, just made me want to work harder, you know, keep the ball high and tight like Tiki Barber's. You know, a lot of coaches just say keep the ball like Tiki Barber high and tight, so you know you won't fumble because it's raining out here in summer, so it's really good for us.
Well, tell me about the celebration tonight.
I mean, it was really good. You know, I was really happy. Me and my teammates, we just come out here and we just worked really hard.
Okay, thanks a lot, Tony.
No problem.
Once again, the final score here from Giant Stadium, the Don Bosco and Bosco Ironmen 35 and the St. Peter's Marauders 15. Don Bosco, another state championship. They haven't lost a game since opening day of 2008 in Ohio. I think this team has to leave the country to lose a game. 10 years goes by. I remember it was 10 years ago, playing Bergen Catholic for a title in your first year. Look at what this program has done in 10 years.
Yeah, you're right about that. It's been a great 10 years. You know, we're really proud of where, you know, the direction this program's gone. It's taken a lot of hard work, and you know, we've been blessed by it. So.